That rod leads to Conifer. You want to go to South Park, you got to go down that rod. Of course, I ain't never seen anyone go up that rod. 6 years ago, a group of campers went up there and got lost. Had to eat each other to stay alive. Used to be the way to the O'Reilly house. He butchered over 50 children and kept their bodies in a cellar. But you should find an old bridge about halfway up. That bridge is cursed, you know. They built it with the bones of 200 Chinese laborers who were massacred in 34. Yeah, a lot of history on that rod.
How bad can the K-13 be?
The K-13? You don't want to go down that run. That run's got a history. 35 people have died going down it, and some say you can still see their ghosts up there. That was on that very ski run that a group of students were killed by a wolf boy who escaped from the mental institution. You see, that ski run was once a burial ground to a tribe of vampire Wichita Indians who ate the flesh of children with no eyes. Yeah, a lot of history on that ski run.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Oh, Butters. Oh, Butters, I miss you so much.
Mr. Starch, I know what you're thinking.
Who are you?
I came to talk you out of it. You need to just accept that your son is dead. Not try to bring him back.
Bring him back? What are you talking about?
I know you're thinking of putting him up there. The Indian burial ground up that rod. You're thinking if you bury his body there, it will come back to life. But sometimes, dead is better.
Indian burial ground?
It's been done before, what you're thinking of. The Nelson boy, back in 85.
You're saying if I dig up my son's body and rebury him at the old Indian burial ground that I...
Don't do it, Starch. What comes out of the ground ain't the thing you put in. The Indians knew that. That's why they stopped using it when the ground went sour. I'm just here to talk you out of it. Don't bury your son's body at the Indian burial ground, Starch. The one that's right up over there, behind the Anderson's barn. Sometimes, dead is better.
Yeah, there's a price to be paid with having things convenient. Used to be, a man had to go to the store to buy himself a pitcher of milk. Yeah, but men got lazy. They wanted that milk delivered right to the door. Only problem was, the guy delivering that milk ended up fucking your wife. Sure, you had your nice cold milk delivered right to your doorstep, but your wife was getting pounded out like a mallard duck. And now you got your Amazon. And the milkman's come back. And none of you are safe.
It's over. But you were wrong. We don't have to be afraid of Amazon. The only price to be paid for convenience is that we must be secure with ourselves.
Yeah. Got yourselves some nice home security systems, don't ya? Paying a man to do your job of protecting your house. Only problem is, while you're out feeling like your things are safe, that security man is fucking your wife. Don't know what makes them so popular. I've had to get rid of all my pumpkins, my onions, and my peppers, just to make room for more member berries.
Oh my god, there's this many?
Remember the 80s?
That's the mummy of Tuktan Ra. You don't want to put that stamp in your sticker book. Nobody puts that stamp in their sticker book.
But this is my last one!
It's got a curse on it. Ancient love curse, not fit for any child. You can look at the mummy all you like, but you don't want that stamp in your sticker book.